cigonha, mabaki, tibaba.
Lion King is the musical. It's 15th year grossing, one of the highest grossing shows in Broadway history. And two of the performers that are in town in the show are with me, Nick Cordileone and Ben Lipitz. Gentlemen, Timon and Pumba.
Perfect.
I was about to say Timon and Pumba.
That's better.
That's the first letter. You know.
Blend them together. Exactly.
My favorite. Baba Timba, Baba Tita.
Yeah,
something like that.
We try to do that.
Yeah. We never can.
You're telling me I should try either, right?
No, I'm not. That was actually really good.
You hear that, and it just, you sit up straight because you're ready for the show. You guys are ready to perform.
And that's exactly what it is. It's Rafiki's call to the animal kingdom to pay attention to the birth of the king.
Talk about being part of a show like this. It just seems like it would be so much fun with the rich history behind it. The film re-released, did gangbusters again. Talk about being part of this Disney history.
Yeah, it's incredible. I mean, it really is. You have to pinch yourself every day because we're usually sitting in the makeup chair when that Circle of Life call happens. And you still...
That one. Yeah.
I felt like we were in the theater right now.
Okay, good. I wanted to put you back up.
The hair on your arm starts to stand up. Yeah. You're like, how am I a part of this? It's incredible. And you get to, just coming to the theater, walking through the audience who are coming to see the show, you can't help but feel like you're getting ready to get on a roller coaster. And it's really fun.
Now, talk about that first line of animals coming in the theater.
In the Circle of Life?
It's just amazing to experience that. And kids just get so excited. Don't they?
I think everyone gets excited, adults and kids, because Julie Taymor, the director of The Lion King, designed that number to be a representation of life. Mm-hmm. And when you see these puppets on the stage and you know that they're performers, and yet you see the majesty and grace of how they move, you can't help but be blown away.
Yeah, very cool. Talk about performing at different venues. We were talking about where I saw the show first, which I've seen it a few times, and I saw it at the Masonic the first time I saw it.
Yes.
Is it difficult to adapt to the different venues as you travel, not only around our city, but the country?
Yeah, it's difficult to adapt to the venues, to the climate. I mean, I think audiences take for granted that, they're seeing the show, but when we come into a city, we've rehearsed all day, we have a show that night, we're in new places with new climate, new humidity, everyone's a singer, so everyone's taking incredible care of their instrument and their bodies, and it puts us through the ringer to travel, but somehow the show goes on and everybody rises right up.
Okay, let's get a little inside baseball for a second. You guys are on stage, what are you looking at? Are you looking at the performer's eyes or are you looking at the puppet's eyes?
We look at each other.
Yeah, we're directed to look. Our eyes meet so that our puppets' eyes meet.
Yeah,
the way
so
our puppets are designed.
It's two things happening.
That is happening.
So it's both.
Yeah.
Yes, for us.
Yeah.
Other characters in the piece are directed for the human eyes to look into the puppet eyes, so that they're connecting to the puppet rather than to us.
Yeah.
So
there's a lot of layers. Yeah. Well, you'll watch young Simba only addressing Scar's mask, where it's this really funny disconnect where you're like, oh, and then when Mufasa actually takes his mask off, it's a really palpable moment where you're like, oh, wow, what's going to happen here?
Because I was watching that the second or third time I saw the show. I was watching to see, because whatever it is, it makes it so very real for us, audience members.
Nice.
It's a very good thing. Talk about some of the comments you get back from people who've seen the show, especially the kids.
Well, you're much smaller than I thought you were. Pumba's this 8-foot puppet, I have 3 feet of hair, and they're like, you play Pumba? God, you're so small. And I'm not, but...
That's exactly. I always am asked, why are you green? And I ask them, why do you think I'm green? And they usually come up with the perfect answer, which is, are you supposed to be, the grass or the foliage behind the puppet? And I'm like, yeah, that's me.
Nice.
So, yeah, it's a neat way to sort of camouflage and yet still be seen. If you want to watch me, you can. So,
very cool. What can people expect when they see you hit the stage here in Detroit for the show?
When they see us or when they see the show?
When they see the show in general, I say you hit the stage.
And then
I mean the show.
Yeah.
I think they see a tremendous heart. I think they see a spectacular story told in grand fashion that resonates to everyone. Everyone wants to find their way in the world.
Yeah, they also see, you know, 50-plus people in front of them having a blast. I mean, yeah. We're just having a great time. We're a huge family out here on the road together, so we really get close. And there's something that you won't see in productions that don't travel. You get to see this really, like, electric chemistry. Mm. So, yeah.
Isn't there a cast member from Detroit, I think? Is Teresa, there a cast member from Detroit?
There sure is.
Yes.
Yeah, from Oak Park, Farmington Hills.
Yep,
yeah.
John Sloan, he's in our ensemble. He understudies Banzai.
He glows when you see on stage because we're here.
Well, just let people know that he's still working. So his people out there, he's still in there.
He is. And he joined the company just over 5 years ago, right before we came to Detroit the first time. And
very cool.
It's a great homecoming for him.
Always got to give hometown shout-outs.
Yeah, definitely.
Thanks, guys, for coming in. I really appreciate it. You see all the information on your screen for The Lion King right there. It is playing through March the 10th. All the information, of course, is on our website at myfoxdetroit.com.